Hi, hello there. My name is Kayla and welcome to my channel. Thank you so much for being here with me today. I really appreciate it. In today's video, we are reviewing the brand new Kylie Cosmetics Sailor Collection. Not the whole collection, just the eyeshadow palette and the lip kit. These are what I purchased from the collection. I passed on the lip gloss, the eyelashes, and the eyeshadow sticks just because I didn't feel like I really needed them. I just wanted the meat and potatoes of the collection, if you would say. This eyeshadow palette does come with 16 shades. You get 8 matte shades and 8 glitter / shimmer shades. It does come with a big, beautiful mirror, which is really nice. On the front of the packaging, you have Kylie Jenner herself as a little sailor girl. And on the back of it, you have all of these shade names. And this eyeshadow palette retails for $44. When I last checked, this was still available on her website. And for the lip kit, it comes in this absolutely beautiful sailor nautical packaging. So cute. Inside, you have the liquid lipstick in the shade Kiss Me Sailor with the matching lip liner. And this lip kit retails for $29. When I last checked, this was also still available on her website. So I gotta say, I absolutely love the packaging of this. I love the theme of this collection. Before this, I had never tried out any of Kylie's eyeshadows. None of them just ever really stood out to me, but when I saw this collection, so cute, I wanted it. So I'm really happy that I was able to get it. So if you like Kylie Jenner, if you don't like Kylie Jenner, if you like sailor stuff, and if you'd like to see how to get this look, then keep on watching. Alright, and before we get into this look, I will go ahead and do swatches of all of the colors on my arm here for you. Here are all of the shades from the first two rows swatched. And here are all the shades from the last two rows swatched. Alright, so every single shade swatched absolutely
beautifully.
Very, very impressed. So if you'd like to see how to get this look and my thoughts and opinions on the new Kylie Jenner Sailor Collection, then keep on watching. Alright, so as you can see here, I did already go ahead and put on my full face of makeup so we can get right into these eyeshadows. I've never tried out any Kylie Jenner eyeshadows before, so this is going to be very interesting to try out her formula. I've never tried it before. I'm very excited about this. The first shade I'm going to take from this palette is the shade Slay Captain on my Morphe M535 brush and use this as a transition shade and put this all along my crease. I am going to go ahead and mention, I thought this palette was going to be a lot bigger. It's smaller than what I anticipated, but it's still really cute and very pretty. I'm not sure if you guys can see this, but I did have quite a bit of fallout with this shade. I mentioned this in my previous videos. I don't really mind when a color has fallout in the pan. Not a big problem to me as long as it blends out nicely and there's little to no fallout on my actual face. Okay, so that color did lay nicely on my eyes. There was little to no fallout with it, and it blended out very well. Next shade I'm going to take from this palette is the shade Tight Ship on a Morphe M433 brush, and place this in my crease as well, just right below where I put the transition shade. Right off the bat, not sure if you guys can quite see that, but there's definitely quite a bit of fallout in the pan with this shade. There is a whole bunch on my brush. Just be aware of that. Now I'm just going back in with my Morphe M535 brush and just lightly buffing this out. Alright, so that color laid very well on top of the Slay Captain color. I really like how it's looking right now. I'm going to take a little bit of the shade Tidal Wave on my Morphe M152 brush and place this right on my outer corner and bringing it up a little bit into the crease, right into like the center of my eye. Now I'm taking a little bit of the shade Wavy on the same Morphe M152 brush and placing this just right on my outer corner. Now I'm taking a tiny bit of the shade On Board on the same Morphe M152 brush and just lightly placing this on the outer corner. Okay, so as of right now, we would have a very nice neutral eye look going on, but I do want to spice it up a little bit. So I think I'm going to take a little bit of the shade Blue Ocean on a MAC 213 brush and place this on my outer corner and just bring it a little bit upwards. And I'm just taking my Morphe M433 brush and lightly blending it out a little bit. All right, so far we're doing pretty good. I did have to work with that blue shade for a little bit, but I think I got it to where I want it to be. Now, I really want to go into the glitters, but before I do that, I'm going to do a little cut crease moment. And for this, I'm using my P. Louise eyeshadow primer base and my Laura Lee Los Angeles L17 brush and just carving it out. Alright, so I went ahead and carved out my crease. To set the crease, I did use a little bit of my Kimchi Chic Puff Puff Pass powder. Now for the glitters, I don't know what to use. I'm gonna take a little bit of the shade Deep Sea on a Morphe 124 brush and place this on the outer corner of my lid right next to where the blue shade is.
Wow!
I'm gonna take my finger. Yeah, it worked a lot better with my finger. Now I'm going to dip my finger into the shade Unsinkable and place this on the center of my lid. And a little bit into the shade Go With The Flow and just pop this on there too. Now for the lower lash line, I'm going to take the shade Tight Ship on my Morphe M506 brush and place this all along my lower lash line. Now I'm taking a little bit of the shade Tidal Wave on the same Morphe M506 brush and placing this on the outer corner of my lash line. Now I'm taking a teeny tiny hint of the shade Blue Ocean on a Morphe 508 brush and lightly just stamping this on my outer corner. Okay, so I'm really liking the way this eyeshadow looks so far. Aside from the blue shade, I've had some issues with it. It's not blending out like I want it to, and it's looking just a tiny bit patchy. I'm gonna go ahead and do eyeliner and eyelashes off camera, come back, and we'll get into the liquid lipstick. Alright, so I went ahead and applied my eyeliner and eyelashes, and I think this look is really coming together. It looks so cute. Kylie did release eyelashes with this collection. However, I did not pick them up. Why? Because I just don't need them. And they looked kind of small, like size-wise. I, fortunately, never have to cut my eyelashes down or anything like that. I guess I just have wide eyeballs. Not sure. But they just looked kind of small. And I didn't think they'd be big enough to fit my eyes. So I didn't pick them up. And I have a whole bunch of other eyelashes laying around. So I just didn't get them. But I did get the lip kit in the shade Kiss Me Sailor. I'm so excited to try this out. I have tried out a Kylie lip kit before. It was one of her Halloween fall collections, I believe. It was a really pretty gray sort of mauve-y color. I think it was in the shade Moon. I think the packaging on this is absolutely
adorable.
It's just a like soft matte sort of packaging, but it has like texture on it. Super cute. I love it. And this is what the liquid lipstick and the lip liner look like. So cute. I love the little cursive rope font going on here.
So adorable.
So first we're gonna line our lips. Oh wow. I didn't swatch this or anything yet, and I'm surprised at how brown this lip liner is. It's really cute though. Now for the liquid lipstick. It smells really good. This is definitely reminding me of the previous liquid lipstick I had from her. Love the smell of it. It smells like vanilla cake. Alright you guys, so this is the final look. At the end of it, I really like the way all of this came together. It looks so cute. I feel really pretty today and it looks really, really nice. So altogether, my final thoughts on the Kylie Jenner Sailor palette. I really liked it. The colors in here are absolutely beautiful. I'm really happy that I picked it up. However, I did have some problems with this little blue shade. He did not want to cooperate with me. It took a lot of work to get it to do this, and I'm not 100% happy with how the blue looks. I do see like a little tiny bit of patchiness on my outer corner with it. Aside from that, I really liked all the other shades that I tried, and I will most certainly be using this palette again. I think I just have to keep playing with this blue shade and see how I can get it to work. But aside from that, I will most certainly be using this palette again. I really enjoyed it. I love the colors in here. You can most certainly create a nice, natural sort of smoky eye with this palette, or you can have some fun with the reds and the blues and all the glitters and make a really fun look. And as far as the liquid lipstick and the lip liner go, it looks so pretty. It does look darker than I expected it to. I thought it was going to be lighter, but I'm not really mad at it. It looks good. It's just not what I was expecting. So yeah, as far as the Sailor collection goes, as far as everything that I tried out from that collection, I really liked everything. I just have to work with that blue shade a little bit more. But aside from that, I'm really happy with my purchases and I will most definitely be using these pretty often in the future. All right, you guys. So that is it for today's video. If you liked this video, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel. Everything that I have on my face will be linked in the description box down below, as well as all of my social medias, my Twitter, Instagram, I'm everywhere. Sound off in the comments if you liked this look I created, if you purchased the Sailor palette or anything from the Sailor collection, and if you liked what you purchased as well as I did. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Bye.